Warm wishes to one and all. We are entering into the third session of heights and distance. Okay, we can observe some more different type of examples. Okay, here they are given one of the example: a vertical tower stands on a horizontal plane and is surmounted by a vertical flagstaff of height h. Okay, a vertical tower it is there. Here this is vertical tower on a horizontal plane. Okay, here this is vertical tower. From this they are taken a vertical flagstaff, surmounted by a vertical flagstaff means here the flagstaff is there, staff is there, of height h meter. That means here to here height is h meter. That is, we can give the name, we have to take the some point on a plane, the angle of elevation from the bottom and top of the flagstaff is alpha and beta. That means bottom is this one, top is this one. We are observing the angle of elevation, then this is alpha they are given, this one is they are given beta. This is alpha and this one we are getting beta. We got it, two right angle triangles, we can give the names. Here it is A, B, C, D. CD length, that is CD is nothing but flagstaff. Flagstaff is height h. We want to find what is that height of the tower. That means BC we have to find. From that one we have to take a we have to take a triangle ABC. When we are taking the triangle ABC, we can apply tan alpha. Why we are taking tan alpha means we related to this side and this side. Why we are taking these two only means when we are taking the whole also it is related to AB only, that's why we are taking AB. Then we can take tan alpha. What is tan alpha means opposite. Whenever we are taking this is the angle alpha, then this will become opposite, this will become adjacent. That means opposite by opposite is BC by adjacent is AB. We want to find AB length. Then when you do the cross multiplication, AB is equal to what you are getting is BC by tan alpha. We got it. AB is equal to BC by tan alpha. When we have to take another triangle, triangle ABD. I am taking triangle ABD. When you have to, from the triangle, we can take an angle tan beta. When we are taking tan beta, then opposite side become BD. Opposite side become BD by adjacent is AB. Just here once observe, tan beta into AB is equal to BD can be written as BC plus CD. You can write that is nothing but BC plus CD. CD is nothing but H. Then once you can observe, what is AB means BC by tan alpha. That means tan beta into BC by tan alpha is equal to BC plus H. Just tan alpha will send to that side means multiplication. Then what you are getting is BC into tan beta is equal to tan alpha into BC plus tan alpha into H. Just here once the this BC into tan alpha will send to this side. BC into tan alpha will send to this side means then what you are getting means just here once of the BC into tan beta minus BC into tan alpha is equal to H into tan alpha. When you take BC is common, then what you are getting tan beta minus tan alpha is equal to H into tan alpha. We want BC only. Why? Because we want to find the height of a tower, BC only. We want to BC means into tan beta minus tan alpha will send to that side means division. That means then just here once of the BC is equal to what you can get? H into tan alpha by tan beta minus tan alpha. That is height of a tower. We can observe the next example. An aeroplane is flying horizontally 1 kilometer above the ground. 1 kilometer above the ground. This is ground. Aeroplane is moving 1 kilometer above the ground. That is nothing but 1 kilometer is nothing but we have to convert into meter, means 1000 meter. Okay, it is 1000 meters above the ground. 1000 meter above the ground. The angle of elevation we have to observe from this point. Okay, the angle of elevation here from observe this point is 60 degrees. Okay, after 10 seconds. Okay, after 10 seconds, the angle of elevation. Okay, after 10 seconds, the aeroplane is moving somewhat far. Okay, then the angle of elevation. Okay, here the angle of elevation is 30 degrees. Okay, when you join with the base here, this is also height is same, 1000 meters only. Okay, then we have to find the speed of a aeroplane per hour. Okay, just we want to find the distance between these two part. Okay, nothing but this distance is nothing but this distance. When you got it, this distance, okay, we know the time. Okay, how much distance, how much time it is traveled to this distance is 10 seconds. Okay, we know the distance and time. We have to find the speed, it is easy. That means we have to find here, when we are taking here, BC length we have to find. Okay, BC length we have to find from the triangle. Okay, here we have a two right angle triangle. One is ABE right angle triangle, another one is ACD right angle triangle. Okay, just I'm taking first triangle ABE. Okay, when we are taking ABE right angle triangle, then we can take tan 60 degrees. Tan 60 degrees means opposite from this ABE triangle. Opposite is, okay, here 1000 meter. Why? Because height of a, okay, how much height it is flying is 1 kilometer means 1000 meter. Nothing but 1000 meter height. Opposite we know 1000 by AB. 1000 by AB. Okay, here tan 60 value we know root 3 is equal to 1000 by AB. Just when you do simplification, then AB is equal to 1000 by root 3. Here it is irrational, means we have to rationalize, then it is become AB is equal to what we are getting is 1000 root 3 by 3. Okay, we got it 1000 root 3 by 3 meters. Okay, next from the triangle ACD, when we are taking the full triangle ACD, we can apply again tan 30. Again here it is opposite. Opposite is nothing but how much height it is flying is 1000 meters only. Okay, opposite is 1000 by adjacent is AC, full length is AC. Okay, tan 30 value 1 by root 3 is equal to 1000 by AC. When you do the cross multiplication, then AC is equal to what we are getting 1000 into root 3 meters. Okay, we want to find the BC length. Okay, how we can find the BC length means BC is equal to AC minus AB, we can write. That means BC is equal to AC minus AB. Okay, what is AC value we are getting? 1000 root 3 minus 1000 root 3 by 3. Okay, when you simplify this one, what you are getting means 3000 root 3 minus 1000 root 3 by 3. That is BC is equal to how much we are getting means 2000 root 3 by 3. We are getting, this is PC value 2000 root 3 by 3 meters. Okay, we got it. How much distance it traveled in 10 seconds means, okay, 2000 root 3 by 3 meter. We want to find speed. Okay, we know the distance, how much distance it traveled means 2000 root 3 by 3 meters. We know the time is 10 seconds. We want to find speed. Speed is equal to distance by time formula. Speed is equal to distance by time. Distance is equal to how much means 2000 root 3 by 3 whole by time is 10 seconds. Okay, when you simplify this one, speed is equal to what you are getting means 2000 root 3 by 3 into 10 here, 0, 0 cancels, then speed is equal to 2000 root 3 by 3. Okay. Here it is in meter per second. Okay, we want to convert into per hour. Per hour means kilometer per hour. Okay, meter per second. speed meter per second we have to convert into kilometer per hour means we need to multiply with 18 by 5. That means okay, when you multiply with this one with 18 by 5, then it can be convert into when you multiply with 18 by 5, it can be convert into kilometer per hour. Okay, when you simplify here, okay, 5 table here it is 40 times, 3 table here it is 6 times. That means S is equal to 46 240 root 3 kilometer per hour. That means for every hour it will be traveled 240 root 3 kilometers. Okay, that means speed of a aeroplane is 240 root 3 kilometer per hour. Okay, we can observe the next example. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower from a certain point is 30 degrees. Okay, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower from certain point. Okay, from certain point the angle of elevation they are given. Okay, here 30 degrees. And afterward is there given, if the observer moves 20 meter towards the tower. Okay, here the observer it is there, it moves, he moves 20 meter towards the tower, and the angle of elevation will be increased by 15 degrees. That means here it is, whenever the line of observation is nearest to the vertical line, then angle will be increased. How much angle here it is increased means 15 degrees. That means 30 degrees to it will be increased somewhere 15 degrees. That means it will become 45 degrees. This will become 45 degrees. They are given how much of distance here to here means 20 meter. That is, they are given name, we can give the names A, B, C, D. Okay, then we have to find the height of the tower. We have to find that the height of the tower means CD value. Okay, we have to take a two right angle triangles here from triangle BCD. We are taking the triangle BCD. We can apply tan 45. Tan 45 is equal to, whenever this is a angle, then this will become opposite. Here it is right angle triangle. This will become opposite. This will become adjacent. Then what you can write? Opposite CD by, okay, adjacent is BC. Tan 45 value is 1. 1 is equal to CD by BC. When you do the cross multiplication, then BC is equal to CD. We got it. BC is equal to CD. Now we can observe the next triangle, triangle ACD. We can take the next triangle, triangle ACD. Okay, triangle ACD. When we are taking the triangle ACD, we can apply tan 30. Tan 30 is equal to opposite is CD by adjacent is AC. Okay, just here once of the, okay, tan 30 value is 1 by root 3 is equal to CD by AC. Okay, just here once of the AC is equal to what we are getting, root 3 into CD. Just here now we know AB length. Okay, what is AB means, related to this full side. We have to find the AB means, how we can find means, AC minus BC is nothing but, okay, 20. Okay, then we have, they are, when we have to take a, find AB is equal to, what we can write, AB is equal to AC minus BC we can write. Okay, AB how much they are given means 20 meter. What is AC we are getting means root 3 into CD. Minus BC means, BC is nothing but CD. Okay. When we are taking the CD is common, when we are getting the CD is common, that is nothing but root 3 minus 1, which is equal to 20. We want to find the CD. CD is equal to 20 by root 3 minus 1. Okay, they are given units is meter. Then it is CD is equal to root 3 minus 1. But okay, 20 by root 3 minus 1 meter. Okay, whenever the denominator is irrational, we can do the rationalization. What is rationalizing factor of root 3 minus 1 means root 3 plus 1. When you multiply and divide with root 3 plus 1, then what we are getting means, just okay, when you simplify this one means, we are getting the 20 into root 3 plus 1 by 2. 2 it is there 10 times, then it is nothing but 10 into root 3 plus 1 meters. Okay, just either they are given option, either this one or this one. Okay, we can observe the next example. If from the top of the cliff of 150 meter high, the angle of depression of the two boards. Okay, they are given a cliff of 150 meters height. Okay, this is 150 meter height. Okay, from the top of the cliff. cliff they are observing the two boats which are due to north of the observer. Which are due to north of the observer means nothing but same side. Okay, here the two boats are there. Here it is two boats. This is one first boat and this is second boat. Okay, they are observing from the top of the cliff. Okay, the angle of depression they are given. Whenever the angle of depression is they are given, we have to take the line of horizontal line. Okay, this is 30 degrees and this is 60 degrees. Okay, whenever these two horizontal line and bases are parallel, okay, we can take these two lines are transversal. Whenever the transversal drawn from a two parallel lines, alternate interior angles are equal, then this is 30 degrees means then this is also 30 degrees and this is 60 degrees. Okay, we got it. Okay, then we can give the names. Here it is A, B, C, D. Okay, then we have to find the distance between the two boats. Okay, one of the boat is at B and another boat at a C. We have to find the BC. Okay, how we can find where BC means, we can take the two triangles here, two right angle triangles. Okay, one of the right angle triangle is ABD. We have to take one of the right angle triangle ABD, tan 60. Then you apply tan 60. What is tan 60 means opposite. Whenever this is the angle, then this is opposite, this is adjacent. That means opposite is 150 by adjacent is AB. Tan 60 value is how much means root 3. Root 3 is equal to 150 by AB. Okay, then we have to find AB. What is AB means 150 by root 3. When you take the rationalization, root 3 into denominator, we can multiply root 3 again. Then when you simplify this one means what you are getting means 150 into root 3 by 3. 3 table here it is 50 10. That means AB is equal to 50 root 3 meters. Okay, we got it. AB is equal to 50 root 3 meter. Then we can take the another triangle. What is another triangle means ACD. Okay, from that ACD triangle we can apply tan 30. Tan 30 degrees is equal to tan 30 degrees opposite is 150 meter by adjacent is AC. Tan 30 means 1 by root 3 is equal to 150 by AC. When you do the cross multiplication, then AC is equal to 150 root 3 meter. We got it AC. Okay, we want to find the distance between these two ports. That is nothing but BC. BC is equal to what we can write? BC is equal to what we can write means AB minus AC minus AB we can write. Okay, then BC is equal to AC is how much means 150 root 3 minus AB means 50 root 3. Then BC is equal to how much means 100 root 3 meters. We got it. BC length, that is nothing but distance between the two boards is 100 root 3 meters. Okay, we can observe the next example. A contractor plans to install a two slides for the children to play in a park of for the children below of the age 5 years. She prefer to have a slide whose top is at a height of 1.5 meter. That means they want to install a slide of height from the ground. Okay, here it is from 1.5 meters height. Okay, they want to install a slide of inclination they are given 30 degrees. Okay, for the age of children, okay, it will form a right angle triangle. Okay, the same way for the elders, they want to install an at height. Okay, somewhat height it is increases, this total height become 3 meter. Okay, we want to install a slide. Okay, of an angle is 60 degrees. This is 60 degrees. Okay, now we are getting a two right angle triangles. We want to find the length of each slide. Okay, that means nothing but AC length and AD length we have to find. Okay, we have to take a triangle ABC. From the triangle ABC we can apply sin 30. Why we are taking sin 30 here? In this triangle angle is 30 degrees. Okay, opposite side is given and hypotenuse we have to find. That means we have to take sin 30 degrees is equal to sin 30 means opposite is 1.5 by hypotenuse is AC. Okay, sine 30 value is 1 by 2 is equal to 1.5 by AC. When you do the cross multiplication, then AC is equal to how much we are getting is 2 into 1.5. That is AC is equal to 3 meters. Okay, we got it. The length of a one slide is 3 meter. In the same way, we can take another triangle, that is triangle ABD. We can take. When you take the ABD triangle, we can apply tan 60. Sorry, we are taking sine 60. We are taking sine 60. Why again we are taking sine 60 here? Means, okay, they are given angle 60 degrees. Opposite side is 3 meter. They are given. We have to find hypotenuse. That's why opposite is 3 pi. Hypotenuse is AD. Okay, sine 60 value is root 3 by 2, which is equal to 3 by AD. When you do the cross multiplication, what you are getting is root 3 into AD is equal to 6. We want AD value. AD is equal to 6 by root 3. When you have to rationalize, okay, then we have to multiply and divide with the root 3 into root 3. Then when you simplify this one, means what you can get means 2 root 3, okay, meter. That means okay, we get another slide length is 2 root 3 meter. Okay, for the age of 5 year, the slide length is 3 meter. For the elder people, the slide length is 2 root 3 meters. Thank you.